two equally charged pit balls, each of mass m. Both are suspended from the same point by two slip threads, each of length L. As a result of mutual repulsion, the balls are separated by D. Now we can calculate the charge on each ball. So the tension experienced by the silk thread making an angle theta with equilibrium position. Consider this one pit ball, this is another pit ball. Both are experience repulsive force because both are equally charged and the charge is also same, so that it experiences repulsive force like this. So we have to split the components. So we can split the component of T. So here, since it makes an angle theta with the equilibrium position, so these two angles are alternate angles, both angles are same. So if we consider this is right angle triangle, this is opposite side, so that this is hypotenuse, so that this is T sine theta. And this is adjacent side, this is hypotenuse, so that this component is T cos theta. If it is T sin theta, this is parallel one, so Fe along the repulsive force direction, Fe is nothing but T sin theta. So now from this figure, Fe equal to per equilibrium position, Fe equal to T sin theta, and Mg, because in equilibrium Mg equal to T cos theta. So we know that Fe is nothing but, since both the charges are equal, that constant K, Q square, where K is in vacuum, K equal 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So K Q square by D square is equal to T sin theta. So K Q square D square equal to, from this relation we can get T, so T equal to Mg by cos theta. So we can substitute the value of T here. So instead of T we can use Mg cos theta into sin theta. Or K Q square by D square equal to Mg sin theta cos theta. We can bring the Mg here, so that Q square D square Mg equal to sin theta by cos theta. So sin theta by cos theta is nothing but tan theta. So we can calculate the charge on each balls. So Q square equal to D square Mg tan theta by K, or Q equal to D square Mg tan theta by K whole power 1 by 2, or Q equal to just D square whole power of is D, so D into Mg tan theta by K, Mg tan theta by K whole power of. So substituting the value of D, mass of the pit wall, and the angle made by the tensor of string theta and constant k 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. You can get the charge on each ball.